Hello and welcome to another episode on Diet Diaries with me, Tanvi Sawant. Well, New Year's round the corner and I assume that many of us have already made the resolution list. Well, we all make resolutions, but topping the list would definitely be getting more healthier, more fitter, or something somewhere around their health. So this year, I'm going to stick to my diet plan. This is what we all say. But what happens is, we make all the efforts to, you know, follow that healthful eating habits, and then suddenly, until one fine day, there is a moment of weakness, a hunger strikes us and we are seen indulging into a feeding frenzy. So that happens to all of us. Well, there should be a way to break this vicious cycle. For that, we have come up with an episode on weight management for lifetime. Sounds interesting, right? Okay, so we have with us to guide us through this episode clinical nutritionist and consultant dietitian Shweta Naik, and she has been in this working line for past 4 years. So let's welcome her. Hello, Shweta.
Hello, Tanvi.
How are you?
I'm doing good.
Okay, Shweta. So it is said that, and correct me if I'm wrong, weight gain hits a woman after marriage and men after divorce. Sadly, it's true.
Yes, it is true for women after a marriage, because there are a lot of changes which she have to go, like emotional changes and a lot of other things, like she change her house, so food changes and many other things happen. And for men also, when he goes under maybe a repression or a sad, again it is emotional. So emotional imbalance is happening and that's how they tend to gain weight.
So here comes the concept of weight management. So would you tell us what is exactly weight management?
Yes, very good question, Tanvi. Weight management is something very, you know, it's an approach towards a healthy life for a lifetime, wherein you need to maintain whatever weight you have lost. So one should, you know, have a goal toward it. Okay, how do I maintain it? Because it just happened, it cannot happen like that only. You have lost weight and you need to maintain. So it will maintain by your own. No. You need to work hard for it. You need to intentionally be a little focused. Okay, what you are eating, having a balanced meal or not. Okay, so you need to follow all particular, you know, pattern about your meal. Then your physical activity need to be proper. Then if you are having any bad habits of eating, like if you are going out, you are indulging everything and anything you are eating. So you need to correct yourself and maintain your weight on your own throughout the life, so you lead a healthy life.
Okay, so when should one start, you know, your weight management? You cannot start it like from your teenage age or whatever that age,
particular age is. I think weight management, one should understand where her or his body lie, and then one should take a step for a weight loss, you know, any kind of medical issues if he or she is having, and based on that, when the goal is achieved, then you need to maintain it forever for your lifetime. So weight management is like an everyday process. You need to eat correct, have good physical activity, need to have a proper balance, you know, analyze your body in case you're having kind of, you know, medical issues, or if your BMI is not proper. So you need to work with all these factors and go ahead with your weight management for your further journey.
Okay, so as we have taken the topic weight management for lifetime, inverted commas, so is it possible first of all to maintain this weight for a lifetime?
Yes, it is possible for you to maintain your weight for a lifetime. Again, here you need to be very particular about your eating. Okay, your balanced meal, when I say, have whole grain food, have protein content and no food in your diet. See that you are taking proper amount of water throughout the day. Okay, have small meals throughout the day. Second thing is, when it's not only about diet or only about food, again the physical activity also comes. So you need to again have, you know, proper physical activity day to day. So you need to maintain, you need to have a balance. If you're suppose we say calorie in, then there should be a calorie out also. Okay. So when we are incorporating any amount of food, we need to give it out. So you know, the eating and physical activity should be in a balanced way, and with that again your lifestyle changes. Like if your habits are not proper again, then you need to, you know, correct yourself. See that portion what you're eating. You need to, you know, keep in mind that you're not eating stressful. You should not emotionally eat, okay? So all these factors are going to take you to manage your weight for lifetime, okay? So this other point I will, you know, want to tell people that, you know, trying to keep your weight in your control. It is in our hand. How do we want to take our health? Suppose if you all are having any kind of medical issues, analyze, like, you know, take care of it, and then balance your eating pattern, your physical activity.
Okay. So, wherever we turn around, we see obese people. You know, obesity has become like just a common. It's a common like trend kind of. So, how do you advise people to maintain or handle this obesity? In young as well as the older adults.
Yes, if we take children or adults, it is like, you know, concern, highest concern of our society today, that if our small children, our teenage or adults are getting into overweight, obesity, and then there are a lot of other health issues also they are suffering from. So it is very important. A first step should be taken within the family itself. Okay, now suppose because the foundation, it's a primary step home. Like whatever family has a habit, like family's eating habit or family, you know, other kind of activities, lifestyle and all, children will adopt. So adapt it. So because in similar way, it will go ahead, and then when they reach in the society, again the society habits they will adapt, like going out with friends and having, you know, some snacks outing or dinner parties and all. So we need to start from the first step, it'll be from home. Encourage your children to have good food. Encourage them to eat, you know, good vegetables, fresh fruits, you know, a home cooked meal. Encourage them with your daily routine, like whenever you are going out for a grocery, whenever you are going for a, you know, vegetable shopping, take them with you all. So they are also involved in it. They know, okay, this color vegetables or particular color fruits are good for them. Because nowadays we see the health hazards are so that, you know, children have started wearing specs from very young age. Then they have, you know, diabetic, cardiovascular, hypertension, then, you know, sleeping disorder, gastric issues from the beginning of the age. So all these things need to be taken care at the early stage only, that's the beginning foundation period of their age. So again, giving them good, lifestyle habits, again, encouraging them to eat correct, giving them importance of nutrition, and then taking them on the correct track, so that will help, you know, the children to take care, or, you know, parents, it will stress the parents also, how do they take care of their children.
Okay, there is one more trend coming up, like the zero calorie diet or zero calorie foods. So what are these zero calorie food, and do you recommend them?
Zero calorie, I will say it is a myth.
Because
calorie is not our enemy, it is our friend. It is in the vital nutrient, again a part for our healthy living, for you know, take our journey through a healthy like, you know, nutritionally further. So calories, I will say every food has a calorie.
Okay,
if even when they claim a zero calorie or a zero calorie diet, or, you know, any kind of food product whichever available, they have a calorie in it, because when we eat them, they are getting digested. Okay, so there should be something, okay, high calorie or low calorie. Like when we talk about low calorie food, it will be like fruits, vegetable in a raw form, or or, you know, some whole grain meals which has a low calorie in it, that are good for us for maintaining our weight, again to control our, you know, other health hazards. And when we say high calorie, like it will be like, you know, cooked food and manner, like biryani or, you know, dal makhani or something which is added, processed and all, that will be a high calorie meal. So we need to be balanced what time what we are eating.
So we'll take a short break here.
Okay,
we'll be right back after a short break. Keep watching Diet Diaries. Welcome after the short break. We are with Shweta Naik, and she is guiding us through weight management for lifetime. Okay, Shweta, so now we've discussed enough. Please guide us. Like, mini meals are said to be, you know, boost, and they boost the metabolism. They keep you, you know, your mood and your energy level stable throughout the day. So how would you guide us through
mini meals? Correct, Tanvi, what you heard. Mini meals, or, you know, small frequent meals, help us to boost our energy. Because when we have the small frequent meals, what happens is, you know, our energy breakdown is happening. The calories are getting burned, and that's how we are getting energy supplied. Again, the nutrients are getting supplied to our body, and then day-to-day work is taken care. And in this, there is no storing of fat. Okay. Because when you're eating continuously, you are giving enough nutrient for your body, you are giving enough energy to yourself. So you don't binge or you don't want to eat anything later on. So I will suggest to boost our metabolism, everybody should have small frequent meal throughout the day. Like your breakfast, it should be a heavy meal. You need to have a midday meal snack, then the lunch should be a proper huge lunch, then a mid-evening snack and the dinner.
So now talking about your exercise, which is quite important to for weight management program. So how would you suggest, or how would you tip your clients?
When if we want to have a very healthy life throughout, and we need to maintain the weight, we also need to have good exercise pattern in our day-to-day schedule.
Correct.
Now I know everybody is busy and cannot remove time, but just 1 hour or 30 or 40 minutes from their daily routine, just for walking, jogging, this will be like cardio, your cardio section of part. But there is again called strength training, your resistance exercise, which include some toning up, your muscle workout. So even both should be in a equally balanced way. You cannot just do cardio only, like dancing and cycling, walking throughout the day. That will improve your energy levels, it will give you good strength, it will have you good flow, you'll feel good about throughout the day. But when you do a strength training also, it will make your bones strong, your body will have a good posture, you'll have a good frame of body, and you'll feel good about it. So both the things should be in a combination. And the bottom line is, don't rush into it. Don't start from you have a sedentary life and suddenly don't start exercising. Yeah. Think what is required for your body and then take a step toward it. Any exercise you pick up, go with a step by step. Don't rush into it. That will be
okay. What are the different types of exercise one can practice?
Practice. Okay, the simple form of exercise can be in a cardio section. Comes as dancing, very easy, basic at home. Yeah. Running, jogging, swimming. Okay, this can be picked up very quickly. You hitting a gym wherein you have proper cardio, and then strength training wherein you need to do your muscle workout, and you need to do a high intensity, low intensity workout. So these are the type of exercise wherein you can work on your daily routine to maintain your weight.
Okay. So which are the supplements, or rather you can say food, which will help in weight loss?
Okay, this is a very good question, because nowadays everybody
wants to
have a magic weight loss, which is just not possible. We need to see that you need to eat correct and lose weight. You cannot achieve weight loss with the supplement. And as a nutritionist, I will say a big no for the supplement, because there are various kind of supplements which are available. Proteins, if you take there are range of protein supplements. If you take a fat burner, there are again the range of fat burners, the herbs are there. So as a nutritionist, it will be a no for any individual, basically, because we have a normal life. We are not going to achieve something, we don't want to have a
title
like body okay, Mr. India or Miss India. We don't want that. When your exercise intensity, when your daily routine is up to the mark, then only you can incorporate a supplement, like when sports person does, when a bodybuilder does. That is okay for them. But for a normal person like us, you and me, or a working person, should not be incorporating supplement in their diet. They should be going with the points which we discussed, like having healthy meal and balanced food, keeping your exercise proper on time, having good sleep, good rest. So this will help them to maintain their weight.
Okay, so how would you recommend, like the store, you talked about fat burners. So the stored fat, everybody is concerned with the stored fat. So how would you recommend how to burn this stored fat?
Okay. When we talk about stored fat, again you need to be very particular, like when your frequent meals will help you.
Okay.
When you have your frequent meal throughout the day, you are distributing your energy levels, you are distributing your intake of the food, wherein it is not getting stored anywhere. So whatever you are eating, it getting consumed as an energy, getting consumed as in a nutrient way, and so you're not storing any food. So balanced eating again required, like whole grain fruit or protein food in your diet, so the satiety value is there. Then you are eating good essential fatty acids, so your fat is getting burned, you're not storing fat again. Then you're taking proper water intake, you're having a cup of green tea. So all this thing will help you to burn fat. Okay, because many times it happens if you are sedentary, you're eating, you're following diet, but you're sitting, there is no physical activity. You are going to gain weight, you are going to store fat, so you need to work it out also. So physical activity is again important here.
Okay, so talking about sugar supplements or sugar substitutes rather, so there is a trend to just put two tablets of that sugar and have a cup of tea, and they're like relaxed. Okay, I'm not consume any calories. So how is your take? What is your take on that?
When we say artificial sugar, again it is a big no as a nutritionist, because sugar substitute or the artificial sugar what we are getting in market itself has a certain amount of calorie.
Okay.
Sad. They are it is really sad. So this thing, there is. There is no scientific evidence anywhere, or there are many research done that they doesn't prove any weight loss or have a control on your sugar balance.
Okay.
Because many times diabetic people have seen taking sugar substitute in their diet. So it is a big no, because they will again worsen your health. They will increase your weight. They will increase your weight. Now when we say sugar substitute, you see there are so many products in market like soft drink, like chewing gums or candies, sugar floss, and so all these things are added with artificial, chemical
based sugars
in it. So it is going to have an adverse effect on our health.
Okay. So now, if talking about sugar and sweets, people have hell lot of cravings for sweets, and including me, I just love sweets. So how would you advise people how to handle their sugar cravings, how to balance that and maintain it?
Okay, when we say craving, it's a great desire to eat something. It's a constant thing in your mind. Okay, I want to eat that. So we need to understand here why we are getting that constant feeling of
eating.
If I'm not hungry, I'm not. If you're hungry, that means you have not provided your body good amount of food throughout the day, and that's why you're getting a craving. Second thing, are you stressed out? Are you having any kind of hormonal imbalance, or are you overweight, or any kind of stress you're going with that? And then the constant thing in your mind is running, okay, I need to eat. Second thing is, again, if you are nutritionally deficient, then again your body start to crave. Like suppose a chocolate's craving come when you are lacking with magnesium, when you are lacking with vitamin B12, okay, even essential fatty acid. So similar way we get a craving to eat something salty. Okay, so here when your electrolyte balance is very less, you crave for salty food. When you crave for something like sandwich or burger, you need to see your sugar is imbalanced. Okay, when you crave for certain product, a nutritional deficiency also shows. So we need to, all these points matter when the cravings start. So one should first give a thought why it is happening. Okay, always question yourself, are you hungry? If you're hungry, then go and have a meal. Okay, if you have missed your meal, or have a fruit. Okay, if you're feeling if you're getting a salty cravings and all, see that you always substitute with something good food with that, and not indulge some wrong food.
Okay, so there's one more question. Suppose you're taking a low calorie diet, in the sense you want to cut down the calories, will fewer calories stall your metabolism in any way?
When you go on a low calorie diet, your metabolism slows down.
Okay,
because you're not providing your body enough nutrient, you're not giving it enough energy. Because you are going with a calorie thinking, I need to have 800 calories or 1000 calories in a day. So you are eating only two meals or three meals maybe in your diet, and that's how it will affect your metabolism, and then it will again tend to gain weight.
Okay, so can you tell us quickly, because I'm talking about weight loss, people are going to kill me because I haven't talked about weight gain, because there are so many people out there who wants to gain weight. We're always talking about losing weight. So how would you recommend, what diet plan would you recommend for weight gain?
For weight gain, again, it should be in a very healthy manner. Weight gainer should not be eating anything and everything.
Correct.
So even for them, it is equally important that they have proper well-balanced diet, wherein they are having food like smoothies or shakes in their diet. Okay, they can have a cheeseburger or cheese sandwiches in their diet. Okay, they can have a paratha with a teaspoon of ghee in their diet. So the food which are and more in calorie, wherein it is going to help them to gain weight. Again, a nutritionist or a diet practitioner should be planning a weight gain diet.
Okay.
Simply going and googling will not help them. So it is again very important, like fruits like, you know, banana, avocado smoothie, for example, you can have, maybe one day you can keep a cheat day for you, mm-hmm. like you can have a pizza and that.
Okay.
So these things will help to gain weight. And you see, what is your goal? Okay, it should not be that you're eating all fatty food and gaining in an unhealthy way.
Good.
So you need to have in a very healthy manner, like divide your meal pattern again. And also keep a physical activity.
They should also keep
a physical activity.
Okay.
Also see their water intake, because again digestion is important for that. Again your water, having a proper meal, so you are supplying proper energy throughout the day is required.
Okay, so the bottom line is if you have gained a particular weight, okay, you have gained a weight or you lost weight and you are at a weight where you want to maintain that weight. So, and how do you tell people, like, instead of continuously losing that weight, how to maintain that particular, you have reached that level, okay, you have to maintain that weight. So how would you go about that?
Once they have achieved their weight loss and their weight gain, they know enough about it. Okay, now I have to go in that particular pattern, because once your biological clock for your body sets, that means you have to be in that routine. You cannot change. Suppose a weight gainer, I'll take. He knows he has to take 5 to 6 meals in throughout the day and a fulling meal with proper calories in that. He cannot just take 3 meals in a day. Again, whatever he has gained, it will come down.
Okay.
Same thing goes for a weight loss also. He have achieved his target and no proper maintaining the diet with having proper meals on time, and suddenly even if he also goes and have just 2 meals or 3 meals in a day, thinking that, you know, okay, now I have lost weight, so I should eat less only, that is not going to help him. So again, here balance eating is very important.
Okay.
Having your meal proper and distribute your calories throughout the day is important.
Okay. We request you to give us a tip of the day since we are at the end of the episode.
If we want to achieve something, we need to work hard for it. So similar way, if you want to achieve a weight gain or a weight loss, we need to work for it. Nothing is going to be easy.
Okay. Thank you for this lovely information, Shweta.
Okay.
Since we have come to the end of the episode, weight management is a long-term approach to healthy lifestyle. So yes, since we know now certain tips and tricks of how to maintain the weight, I hope you're going to start your weight loss or weight gain program shortly. And yes, if you have any comments, any feedbacks, or any other information that you would like us to tell you or you would like us to know, please write to us on email, or you can text us on WhatsApp. Both the email ID and the WhatsApp number is getting flashed onto your screen. So until we meet the next time on Diet Diaries, you guys take care and bye-bye.